starts now.
Evacuation orders from the governor give some families in Dakota Dunes no option but to leave their homes behind. Welcome to KMEG 14 5 o'clock Focus. I'm Michelle Stuhr. For tonight's first focus, we go to KMEG 14's Jordan Furby, who was at the governor's news conference earlier and is live in the middle of what is now Dakota Dunes reality. Jordan?
Yeah, Michelle, it really is hard to believe that behind me once was the 18th green of the Dakota Dunes Country Club. As you can probably see and hear behind us, helicopters are going, trucks are going past, full of dirt. It is pretty much a war zone here. Hard to believe, like I said, that a golf course once was here. Now, earlier this afternoon, South Dakota Governor Dennis Dugard spoke for a little more than an hour at Dakota Valley High School before heading out to survey the levees here in Dakota Dunes. Now, most questions posed for him were ones that many have been focusing on this week, questions about water level, levee completion, and of course, when to evacuate. But when I asked him that some residents have serious concerns about groundwater possibly rising up through the bottom of their homes, he painted a very clear picture of what most in the dunes will eventually be facing.
We may end up losing the ability to deal with structure below ground. I imagine most homes are not going to have significant basements, or if they do, they're going to have terrific sump pumps, and we won't be able to maintain those. It's very unlikely, and so most people should probably expect that their very lowest level, even if the dikes hold, will become inundated.
Now, I made my way through the neighborhoods earlier today, and it's absolutely just stunning to see some of the sights I've been seeing. As I already mentioned, the 18th hole is pretty much dug up. Water has almost engulfed the entire fairway. The dust is another thing that's really big. So many trucks making their way in and out. It's like being in a desert sandstorm. And another thing that jumped out to me was seeing both residents and workers taking pictures of the events. In fact, I spoke with one Mid-American Worker Energy, who, you know, they've been here at the clubhouse shutting off the gas, and he told me he's taking as many pictures as he can because, quote, we won't see anything like this again, at least in our lifetime. So, Michelle, let's hope that we don't see anything even close, remotely close to this anymore, because as you can see behind me, it's a complete disaster zone, and we don't need to see anything more like this ever again.